everyone, and welcome back to me playing Minecraft Regrowth. Okay. So, what I've been doing, I've been doing some stuff upstairs, and I made a bed from all the spider string that I've been, like, murdering. And I've been, like, working on this wheat look through, like, some genetic whatever. I've made the wheat seeds much better than before. I'll show you how that works later on. But, like, meanwhile, there is something downstairs that I, like, want to show you. And it'll give me some time to explain. Like, oh boy. This is the, I think, third episode of this that I've recorded. And, like, yeah. This is the third that I've recorded because I really like this modpack. But, like, I'm pretty sure there's gonna be times where, like, I'm not gonna release a video every week. This is gonna be, like, dated, I'm sure. But, like, yeah. I'm not gonna release a video every week, like, before. I mean, even then, I wasn't doing that much. But still, it's, yeah, it's pretty weird. So, yeah. I'll just upload videos when I feel like it. So, I'll just say, yeah. So, yeah. If I upload a video, like, that's just my free time and I just feel like it. If I don't upload a video, well, yeah. I just didn't feel like it. Sorry. So, yeah, this is what I found, like, this is what I found, a spider spawner, and really, really fortunately, for some reason, there's some, like, lava down here, and some weird gravel patch, and, haha, the spider can't really spawn because the lava's, like, too bright. And, funny enough, there's a chest here. I already looted it because I was scared it, like, burnt to a crisp. Yeah, actually, while that lava is still there, I don't really feel like a huge need to take it away. I mean, like, what it's doing is protecting me from the spider, so I don't care. But yeah, I just wanted to show you this, so in case I wanted to, like, use and farm these spawners for spiders for whatever, then yeah, that's there. At least I know where to get one. There's some dirt here, there's some gravel, which I wasn't expecting. And, like, yeah, I also investigated that, like, here's some lava too. That's gonna be really useful. But, like, I explored down here a little while ago. I got close to it, and then, like, I didn't want to touch it, but, like, it is a thing. It is a thing. It says Imag Phase Liquid. I don't know what that is. I'm assuming it's just something. I don't know what it is, but, like, I'll just leave it alone because I don't want to risk any sort of whatever. And, like, yeah. As far as I can tell, there's, like, nothing down here of worth. Like, there could be, but, like, I don't really care to look right now for more stuff. I mean, I did a little research. There is stuff that's weird underground that's still, like, underground stuff, but yeah. I really should make stairs to preserve my hunger or something. So, yeah, if you like, manage to pause the video and see my inventory, I'm already kinda ready. But look here, I planted some of the weird trees. They, like, yeah, they're clipping into each other. But yeah, it's a lot of wood and stuff. It's pretty interesting. What I'd rather do with these is just, like, climb it from the side and then, like, chop my way into the tree. And then like I feel like most people when they deal with trees is it's like nah, I gotta start from the bottom. But like Minecraft trees doesn't have gravity like that, so it's actually easier to just mine it out the normal way. And by mining it out the normal way, I mean just like digging from the top to the bottom. I mean, like, yeah. In most cases in Minecraft, you're not supposed to like dig straight down because that's an easy way to kill yourself. But like, because it's a tree and you know what's at the bottom, like, I'm pretty sure you're not gonna kill yourself unless you sabotaged yourself into, I don't know, building a tree on top of lava or something. I don't. Whatever. But like, yeah. Yeah, so these weird trees, they give a lot of, like, wood for some strange reason. And like, yeah, the saplings too, they're pretty amazing. Like, I don't know why, I picked the jungle tree before, and it's doing okay, but like, it's weird how very few saplings I'm getting from it. I don't know, maybe it's just the biome being like really terrible for the normal trees. So like here, yeah, I'm getting these autumn logs. There's more than one kind of autumn tree. Here's an acacia tree, acacia, thing. And there's yet another log up there. Like, with these big trees, they're nice, but like, cause like, they provide lots of wood and saplings, but you gotta make sure you get all the logs, or else there's gonna be weird stuff sticking around, and you don't want these, like, leaves in the air when you do your thing. Yeah, the sound of a tool breaking breaks my heart. Which is, like, another concern for me, cause, like, as common as the flint is, and like there's a bunch of like, I look over the horizon, there's a bunch of like flint stuff around, but like, yeah, as common as it is, it's like, it's not gonna stick. It's, the supply I have does not last forever, alright? I gotta find a renewable source sometime, and To be brutally honest, there's not a lot of renewable stuff in this world because I killed it all. So anyway, I decided, you know what, I'm gonna give in and use Bookface, and then I'll like do magic to revive the world. Like, how bad could it be? Turns out there's a lot of weird magic. Like, oh boy. If I don't get a lot of, like, if I don't get a lot of, like, jungle saplings, I'm gonna, like, plant these four spots for jungle seeds, because, jungle saplings. Because, it's actually the best source of wood, not the best source of, like, saplings, though, so I can't do it every time. Well, as long as there's no logs, this'll all decay and drop saplings whenever. What else is new? Oh, right. So I made these things. They're compost bins. And like they make here, let me just show you how it works. Normally it works with plant stuff and one of the things it works on is wheat, which is like pretty cool because my wheat is breeding excellently. I've actually bred some other super plants, but like they're not ready and stuff. But like, yeah. So let's take this stack of wheat and let's put it in the compost bin. You put it in, if you mouse over a square in the compost bin, it'll show you what works in the compost bin. Like if you have too many logs or whatever. It'll take nearly anything, but like 8 items will produce a thing. It produces compost. And compost can be used for, well, a garden trowel, which is a thing you'll need. But, like, I can't make it because, like, I don't have any iron. And, like, it can turn dirt. You combine it with dirt, you can make garden soil. Now, garden soil is like, oh, here's one. Garden soil is a thing you can use, and it's pretty neat. It's required for some plants, for some crossbreeds and some plants, but like yeah, an apple, that's great. But yeah, it's required for some crossbreeds, some weird stuff, and like you can't. Like it's part of progression. You need it to progress. So how am I gonna get whatever material? Well, it's actually easy enough, I guess. Yeah, it's actually kind of easy, but I'll show that in a little bit. I want to show this first. So the Petal Apothecary. We made that last episode, so you can put water in there. Like, I get mine from the beach because I don't want horrible, horrible water. So I get it from here, and then like it said like to make day blooms. I already made some, but if you forgot how to like make it, it's like, hold on. That's not it. Okay, so it needs mystical yellow petals, a orange petal, and a light blue petal. I have another one here. I may as well. So I'll make two more. So put the mystic yellow whatever. Mystic whatever flower in, and you'll get the mystic whatever petals. Like, two for each. So, there's four. There's two orange ones, and then there's two blue ones. Right. And then, after that, we need seeds. Now, the nice thing about it is you can use whatever junk seeds you have. So, like, these mandrakes are pretty lame, so, like, My best mandrakes are being grown here, and they can crossbreed and stuff, and yeah, they'll grow eventually into super things. I'll explain more later. So yeah, I'll just put these in my hotbar so I can show you. All right, so you can put these petals in any order. All you need to do is throw them in with the letter Q button, and make sure that like you're actually putting correct amounts in. So like one of these, you see it floating in there, and if you mouse over it, you can see what's in there. I think you can take it out with an empty hand, I just forgot how. Okay, so an orange one, two yellow ones. Alright, it says this is a valid recipe and it just needs seeds to finish, so I'll toss in the seeds. Bang! I got a new day bloom. It was great. Let's make another one, just you know. Yeah, I have super sugarcane seeds. That whole field is super sugarcane. It's great. It's amazing. Making whatever it is will drain your water, so you'll have to refill it again. It doesn't have to be this kind of water. There's also the brown water, that works fine too. It's water's water. It's just the biome makes it look even uglier than it's supposed to be. So yeah, toss it in. that, and it's valid. Use toss in the seeds too. Bang! All right, there it is. So I completed that quest four times over. There's a quest with like unclaimed reward. So it gives me a choice between day blooms or nightshades. Okay. I did a little like reading on it. I found out how to get out of the introduction thing. That's not what I'm looking for. All right. So the day bloom. Day bloom is the most basic and rudimentary generating flower. Simply put, the okay. So it makes like these are flowers that make mana during the day from sunlight. Okay. Day blooms are classified as passive flowers, which means they will decay after some use. I don't know. Like, I do not think. I don't know. I have no experience with this. This is magic. I have no idea. They also produce feeble. Alright, so they're passive. They make some mana, like really small amounts, and this is how you make it. Like, you can. Whatever. And, there is something to these that I think I'm forgetting, but, like, I don't know. I don't know what some of these are. It's, like, it's super weird. Blah, 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 blah. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know what I'm looking for. It's whatever. Yeah, whatever. So I'm just gonna plonk this down and check it for a little bit. Because I found out that with this book you can shift and I think right click. Okay. So you can directly get to the thing. Yeah. You can directly get to the whatever. You can from like shifting and right clicking with the book out, you can like check. So like yeah, information. Da 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 passive manager. Okay, so it says after 3 days of work it'll go die and stuff and I'll have to make new ones. Whatever. So yeah. It's like, I don't know, really. So this doesn't help me much, because, like, I don't know. Like, I don't know. It's, like, weird. And I guess it's been used a little bit, so I can't really, like, whatever. Anyway, fine. Let's just pick day blooms because the book said before that, like the book said before, the thing doesn't generate super good. All right, so yeah, the spreading love, blah blah blah. First of all, you want to be able to move mana around, which is where mana spreaders come in. Okay. Like, I want to do this mana stuff right now because I hear mana generation really stinks. Like, at the very beginning, I'm pretty sure it's so slow that you'll want to tear your hair out and stuff like that. I mean, I don't know how bad it really is, but like, I'll just assume it's pretty bad. So, what did I need? Ah, yeah, I needed like, living wood? Yeah, I probably need living wood. Like, where did I put all my living, marble, no. Where did I put my living wood? Is it, okay, here's living rock. Ah, here's the living wood. Oh, that reminds me, I really should, like, get the four, like, things. What's it called? Pure daisies. Yeah, I need those four to do work for me. Like, I put them in here. Like, yeah. I need those to do work. So, I think they have to be on dirt. I'm not sure. But no, that's really ugly. Alright, I'll put them in the ground. Like, around the tree so they're not lonely or whatever. Sure, that's fine. Okay. Dirt, pure daisy. Dirt, pure daisy. Yeah, why do I want so many? Well, I'm already producing wood at a horribly fast rate, so I may as well put them to use. So, yeah. So there's enough space for trees and enough space for what these things to make wood whenever I need it. Living wood, whatever. I think I'll need a lot because, I don't know. What I don't have is stone, because stone's like, well, there's plenty underground, but like, I don't have time for that. And, oh, gotta fix my inventory, it's lame. So, where's my living wood? Okay, living wood. There's a couple of things we have to make. Oh, right. I'll need this too, I think. The one extra petal that we had before. Alright, let's go to the crafting table. I always like these things. So, let's see. The first one it wanted was the horn of the thing. Horn of the Wild. So it needs a pasture seed and living wood. Does this not work? Is this not how it works? Oh, I guess it's not filled in. Okay. So here's horn. Here's Horn of the Wild. That's that quest. And then the other thing was a mana the thing. Spreader, yeah. Alright, so it needs the living wood and the mystical thing. Ah, right, you have to shift and left clicked on that question mark to automatically put it there. Alright. There's a mana spreader. Alright. Oh, it's not done. Well, is the other thing done? Yeah, that's done. Do I have space? Yeah, I do. I'll just claim that because whatever. This living wood seems to be okay. Then you'll want to be okay. First you'll need something to shoot the mana, then you want something to store it, which is done with a mana pool. These hold a lot, but if you need a smaller buffer, there's a dilute variant for this very reason. Okay. a mana pool. Now we're actually like gonna be wizards or something. Mana pool. Alright, there's a mana pool, a diluted mana pool, and the others, which we don't need. What do we need for this? Alright, that's a mana pool. What's a diluted one need? Half. Okay, so there's it needed living stone, I think. Where's my living stone? Here it is, living rock. Okay, let's just make that. There it is. Yeah, I have a thing happen. Oh, there's the fireworks. It just went off in one blow. All right. So. Okay. So, a reward. The floral fertilizer, hydrangeas, daybloom, and choice between daybloom or nightshade. We'll pick daybloom again because okay, nightshade only works at night or something, and it only generates like half the mana or something. So I don't wanna deal with that. Oh, okay. Ah, right. Simple farmland is all well and good for basic plants, but if you want to grow anything particularly worthwhile, in the one method is by composting organic material. Da da da. Yeah, I made one of these. Okay, I made one of these. Right. Okay. So, right. I'll mix. I'm lost in my. I have too much stuff. I'm sorry. I'm easily confused. I don't know what I'm looking at. You know, I have some dirt here, some compost here. Let's make like 16. That's enough for one plot of land. Let's turn it to garden soil, and that should be it for that quest. Gives me 16 more compost. Oh. It played twice for me for some reason. I don't know why. Okay. Compost. Done. Specialty soil. Oh. Some other crops require special soils of their own, akin to sugarcane requiring sand, and essence crops requiring garden soil. The one most worth noting is that mushroom spores require mycelium, and this can be obtained by using infestation spores on dirt. What's infestation spores? Okay, that's new to me. Infesting. Okay, what do I need with this? Oh, a mushroom into a mana thing will turn into a okay. So I can use various types of mushrooms. Do I have at least one? I know I saw one. I grew one accidentally. Did I use it for something? Well, I have this, so it counts. I have that, so it counts, I guess. But I need mana, so I'll do that later when I have mana. Okay. You think you may have found a way to produce some better materials. So, to get essence seeds, simply infuse wheat seeds with a bit of mana in a mana pool. Ah, alright. So, for the rest of these, I definitely need the mana pool. Oh, I also need the wand of the forest, I guess. Like the magic-y book. Tells of a wand, which lets you see the flow of mana more clearly. It sounds like it'll be useful. Of course it is. A task where player needs specific items. Okay. Wand of the thing. Wand of... Oh, okay. So there's a variety of wands in various colors. So how do I make these? Ah, all right. All right, so... Okay, so this wand is living wood twigs with mystical petals. How do I make these? Ah, I need more living wood. Which is the exact reason why I set up that thing. The living wood earlier, because I knew I would need this sometime. They're already ready. May as well. I heard like an Enderman-like noise, like outside, I guess. But like, I don't want to deal with them without armor. I've tried. They're very difficult. I think that was in the last episode. Yeah, you probably already seen me die to it. Like, whatever. So, like, yeah, I won't deal with it until I have armor or something. Unless it's very convenient for me to kill it at that moment. Like, it's near my spikes and it's almost dead or whatever. I'm just too scared to deal with it right now. I'll plant more like trees in a bit. Oh, it's already done. Oh boy, where's my gosh dang thing? Where's my jungle saplings? Right, I may as well. Because jungle saplings are like pretty special, in a way. Like, normally you can plant them like that and they'll grow. But I found out there's a really good way to get wood. So, I made that square of dirt over there. It's a 2x2 square of dirt. It's not much, but like, I can plant 4 jungle saplings in a square right next to each other. And what happens is, if it grows, it's gonna be growing into a giant, humongous tree. And sometimes it has vines on it, which is neat. I actually have some vines left over there. But it's like, yeah, it's not a big deal for now, because I can't make a shear for it, so yeah, it's pointless. Oh, yeah, this, yoink. Wait, all right, never mind. I thought I miscounted. Oh boy. Ah, right. So, while I wait for morning, because I can't really do much with the mana thing right now, I'll just explain what I mean by genetically improving these. Because, like, look, I haven't analyzed every crop here, but, like, I know I have at least four crops here that are, like, 10, 10, 10, like, you remember the stats of that other one, right? Like, look, these seeds have growth 10, gain 10, strength 10. That's, as far as I know, that's the max. Like, these are maximum plants. They're awesome. And, like, here's, like, the way I did it, it's, some people like to do other things, but, like, the way I did it is, like, let's pretend that these are the super weak, like whatever crops. So if I plant them here and then place cross crops on the rest of the field, like this is a 4x4 field. So if I do that, they'll eventually, like, because there's no weeds in here, because weeds stink, I guess. There's no weeds here, so you can just freely put that there, and then it'll eventually grow and spread to here, to the opposite corner. By the time these plants get to the opposite corner, these are most likely the most advanced, most powerful seeds like you can get. Like, for example, these potatoes. I grew them up a lot, and so the starting ones I made are like 10, 10, 7. The rest of these are not yet analyzed because like they're just new. They're new. So let me just like I don't have a lot of space. So let me just break this and this and this. Those are the most likely those ones are the most likely to be the best. Like, oh, look here, they're all unidentified, but they're all stacking. Normally they just stack when they're like the same stats, and look, they all have the same stats. So these are the seeds that are the most powerful, most amazing potatoes. They're still potatoes, but like they're pretty impressive. Yeah, I really should set some of these up. Oh boy. Like, yeah, the sun's coming up. I gotta put these somewhere. So, all right, yeah. I can't do it properly without the wood. So I need to make, I mean the wand. So I need to make the wand. Oh boy. So, one, two, three. Three of those sticks. And I needed, like, leaves. I needed, like, coloring. What's my favorite color? What color should I use? Cyan or light blue? Which one looks better here? Oh boy, this. Like, okay. What's the use of this one? All right. What's this look like? Does it look okay? All right. So this is a cyan one. This is a light blue one. I'll go with light blue because whatever. Light blue and yeah, there's no yellow one, so I'll just use light blue because favorite color. It doesn't look like it matters, so yeah. If it does matter and I'm totally screwing myself over, then I'll just make a new one eventually. Or something. So is that done? Okay. Ten more baked potato floral fertilizers. Alright. So, finally. I gotta work on this mana thing now. Now, I know for a fact that, like, this this field's gonna be pretty busy. Like, I only have so much space for plants, and, like, I definitely don't have enough for anything. So, alright, let me just put this mana spreader down. Yoink. And here it is. It It's a spreader. It spreads. Oh. A creeper just died. Excuse me. I don't like creepers, but the gunpowder, rare. Also, yeah, I improved the wall again, so they can't... Spiders cannot climb over it anymore because I have, like, death spikes down there that'll kill them. Oh, he didn't drop anything useful. Oh, well. So, yeah, I made death spikes. Like, they could still get around here, but, like, now if they get around here, they have to go here and then climb this. And then it's much easier to defend. Like because it's walled a little better. Anyway. So, yeah, I have the wand. I have that. I need... Right, let me just bring my shovel. Right. I think I gotta, like... Alright, I'm just following what another guy said, but there might be, like, a good reason to, like, put it like this. Like, yeah. Like, I don't know, something about mana generation being really poor if it doesn't do it like this. No idea. So anyway, yeah. Day blooms, day blooms, day blooms, day blooms. So what I can do is use it together with the wand. Make sure it's a thing. Ah, right. So I gotta click it to make sure it's a thing. It has a mana bar, and it looks like it's empty. But it's all going into this mana spreader, which is fine, I guess. But, like, we don't want it to go into this torch. That's pretty lame. So, I'll just put it over here. So instead of the torch, we'll put it like I don't know. We'll make it point to the mana pool. So it there. See? The mana is going straight into it. If I have the wand, you can see the mana is shooting out from there into this thing. And we can see how much power is going into it. Yeah, the thing at the bottom. It looks like it says the mana is gathering stuff from items. So it'll drain mana out from items. You can shift right click to make it do the opposite, which'll have it give mana to other stuff. So I guess... Right. It'll keep making mana until eventually, I guess these things will eventually, like, fade out or something. I don't know. Like, I don't pay attention to these things. I'm not a wizard yet. Like, yeah. But, you know, even though I'm not a wizard, this is kind of entertaining. Like, look, grass is growing inside, and I do have to kind of make sure they're close enough to the thing so that it's affected. Because I don't want it to just, like, you know, be lame. Oh boy. So I gotta make sure it's dug out. Why am I digging it in the ground? Like... Alright, there's a couple of questions, I guess. So one is, why are you putting them into the ground like this, in a diagonal pattern? Well, I'd be like, well, they need to be in a diagonal pattern because, from what I know, I don't know anything. From what I do know, like, these things need space, space between flowers, or else they don't get mana correctly. So if they're all bunched up, they don't get mana, and it's really lame for them. So if it's like that, then I forgot what function it is. Whatever. So anyway, it needs a space between them. So like, why did I put them in there? Like, why not just in the air? Well, two reasons. One, I think they get distracted if they're next to a flower, but if it's not a flower, like, you know, if it's just dirt, they're fine with it. It's magic, I don't know. And second, like, look how easy it is to, like, walk across it. Like this is very convenient. I'll make a better setup sometime, but like right now I don't feel like it. I still have 7 of these. I guess I'll try to plant them when I can. Ah, right. I gotta check. So look at how much. Look at how much is going in. It's like, this one's getting like kind of a neutral amount of like mana going in and out. I guess that's the level of like the mana. Like, at least these are like close enough to the thing. Actually, wait, this might be too close to the thing. Alright, I have to break this and test it out, because there is a chance this is just kind of like sucking out the power that's supposed to be for this thing. Let me just check it out. Alright. Alright, I'll put it further, like here. It's being blocked by this thing. Alright. Ah, okay. So, the torch can block it. Okay, testing. Is it actually draining from here to there? I have no idea. I guess I can manually drain it like with my wand or something. I don't know. I'm not a great wizard. I have no idea what I'm doing. Oh, it's nighttime. I guess it'll like eventually drain out, because these things don't produce mana at night. Oh well, I may as well just check on them. Alright, they're in a good formation, I guess. I'll just fix that another time. Meanwhile, there's this thing. We could like try it out a little bit. Like, it's dangerous, but I could like try to go outside a bit. Nah, it's too dangerous. There's too many bad things out there. I don't care that much. Alright, so, right, wheat seeds into the thing, which is nice, because like, I do have wheat over here that's been following the same kind of like growing like cycle. So what I normally do is like, after a field is fully grown with the plant growing thing, I basically just murder the entire field. And there will normally be like seeds like this and there, and it's a mess, I know. But it'll eventually turn into like a super crops. So it's a mess right now, but I can deal with it. So I'll just put these spare logs in here. This, oh, that's the wrong box for jungle wood. Garden soil can go in there as well as... Not that. Oh, right. I forgot to mention, like, that treasure chest. Here's the stuff I got. Like, weird essence, iron horse armor when there's no horse. I have no idea what that is. But it's there. Oh boy. So, yeah. Seeds. Must gather more seeds. And, this is very, very badly arranged. But, like, what I want is to get the seeds from the very end and analyze everything. Like, oh, these are the seeds I already analyzed. So, let's put in whatever. I'll check all the seeds after I put them into a chest, and then, like, from there I'll decide which one to become the leader seed, and then which other ones to move on. Like, yeah. Ah, so there's all those seeds, just these remaining seeds left. So, analyze them. There's a way to do this automatically, but I need, like, there's stuff I need and I can't get it because, like, I don't have, you know, the necessary stuff, like iron. So, alright. Seed analysis. The important parts are the top num, the growth and the gain. Strength we don't need so much because there's a no weeds, like I said before. This one looks good. It's a 10-9-7. Like, okay, this one's 10-10-6. 10-8-6. Or where's that 10-10-6? Okay. So, basically, this is the best of the rest of these. And, the rest of these, nah, they're pretty lame. I can go with just that. Right. Oh, I don't want all of them. I'll just make more, crop sticks. There. So after you analyze the seeds, and you can like, oh, you can reset the whole process. Reset the whole process and then put the starting seed in there. And it'll grow, like, that's my icky water over there. Like, but yeah, it'll grow eventually. And these seeds are basically dead to me, so I'll just pick this one, the really weak starter seeds. And I'll use them for the essence thing that it said. Like here, just, oh. I would, but like there's no mana, not enough mana. Mine more mana. Sad. Sad. On the other hand, mandrakes are here. I may as well do it now because, like, it's nighttime. In nighttime, there's a smaller chance of this happening, but, like, if you right-click these, yeah, it'll give out the mandrake root. Yeah. But, like, sometimes, if you're really unlucky, it'll give you a little annoying monster that will give you nausea all the time. And it's very sad. Like, oh look, it's nighttime, so I guess it's not gonna happen. Like, yeah. Alright, so. Yeah, I may as well do it again for here. Destroy crops. Right. Destroy all the crops. And then analyze the mandrakes. Analyze all the seeds. Yes. I'll tell you what, I like doing this, but like I know it's pretty horrible to watch. Oh, wait. Yeah, that's. These are the amazing potato seeds I got as an example. So, mandrake seeds. Like, I guess the most interesting ones are the ones that are like not just single sets of seeds, because if it's just a single set of seeds, it's normally has different stats from all the other seeds in that case. So like, yeah, analyze all the seeds. I mean, that's actually why I have a spare chest. Like, alright, I analyze these seeds, now I have to like go back up, analyze the rest of this stuff. Like, yeah. Any like seeds that I like, oh, that's not seeds. Any seeds that are like under like, I don't know, observation, I put in there. Oh, water. Yeah, if they're under observation, I put them over there, and then they'll that's when I decide to do whatever to them. Like, just analyze this last view. I mean, this is the basis of Agricraft, and Agricraft is nice, but like, still, this isn't a great thing to watch. So I'll be doing other stuff along the way. I just really needed the mana generation to like go on, because like I didn't wanna just like not get mana. Like, let me check if I can toss this in. Can I toss this in? No. Not enough mana. It is actually still giving mana to it, right? Yeah, it is. I guess it's just really slow. I mean, like, let's see. I could use that, the water thing. Yeah, I could. But, like, I don't want to set it up right now. Right. So, the mandrakes. Which one of these mandrakes are the best? That's horrible. Alright. Okay. 4-3. That's 4-4. Oh, that's not the 4-4 one. Let's see. I just want the ones with the best stats and... if they have the most amazing stats, they get to move on. Alright, so those are the best mandrake seeds I have so far. So yeah, I don't actually want a lot of mandrakes because mandrakes are horrible, horrible things. But I think I do need the material for it. So I'll just leave them to propagate and then get just enough mandrakes to like the 10-10-10 sage, like the 10-10-10 stats. And then after that, like, I'll get enough for, like, one field and then swap it out. Because, like, I really don't need an extreme amount of mandrakes, I think. I have no idea, but like I may need them. Well, if I have too many, I could just put them in a compost bin. Which, yeah, which reminds me, I just wanna make sure I don't toss this out yet. Okay, toss them in here. I gotta actually shoot it in there. Toss it in, and it gave me the thing. Essence seeds, hurrah! And now there's no more mana in it again. Wow. So, yeah. So now this other seed is useless. I'll keep the essence seeds for experimental purposes. And these other potatoes I'll work on in a little bit. Like actually, you know what? Since it's already 10-10-10, I may as well just destroy this whole thing. Destroy it, get all the seeds, and then find out I picked up all the seeds. Are they all stacking? Like a lot of them are. So, in most like the most likely thing is, like by the time they reach 10-10-10, their stats don't really go down unless they're destroyed by weeds or some weird farm animal or something. So are these? Oh, these are not 10-10-10. And that's like whatever. So these are 10-10-9. These are 10-10-10. So these can go in there. Okay, 10-10-9, 10-10-7, 10-10-8. Right. So that's all the potato seeds, and I have far too many. Like potatoes. Potato, potato, potato. Like, okay. Too many potatoes. I can't have these many potatoes. I have enough for food, so I'll just dump the rest of these into the compost thing. Make compost stuff. And like, yeah. Do do do. Yeah, I won't miss those. I can get more. I can get more awesome potatoes eventually. So I have these spare seeds. What do I do with these? Well, all right. These. Okay. These are garbage seeds. Like garbage, 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 whatever. So too many seeds. What do you do? Well, all right. You could just try to dump it in lava, but like, it's a long trip down there. I don't want to go. So I'll just dump it in here. Like yeah, they're easily compostable by the thing. So 8 items will turn into one compost. So what fits there? Almost everything, surprisingly. I'm not gonna put the 10 put like the maximum potatoes in there, because that's lame of me. Okay, like, you could just put any amount of seeds in there, it doesn't really matter, but like, I'd rather not have an arrow that's like stuck in this. And it doesn't like take a seed or whatever. I really should cut these trees down eventually. But hey, this plot's available now, so I can work on carrots or a belladonna or whatever. Like between episodes, I'll just work on crossbreeding and whatnot because, as it turns out, there's a quest line here just for crossbreeding. Yeah. So, yeah, if I do one of those, I'll notify you. Oh boy. So we're like 67% complete here. That's 2/3. All right, I made the essence seeds. Essence dust. Oh, right. The tilled garden soil. Actually, yeah, you know what? I'm gonna need a lot of essence, whatever. So, yeah, I may as well use the garden soil now. Like, where is it? It's over here. So, okay. Right, I forgot. You can't actually look at it whenever it's like, yeah. Alright. I'll mine up the regular dirt. There. Regular dirt mined. And I'll put the garden soil right over here. Which looks like dirt, but is more composty. Yeah, composty. So I can till this. Yeah, I can till it. This is great because, like, I thought I needed to till this with a garden trowel thing, but since I don't need to, I can just do this. I can already start the breeding of genetic magical plants. Like, yeah. Truth be told, I'm told this is not the most efficient way to do it, but if you're needing a lot of the... If you need, like, the crops to, you know, proceed or something, you'll want a big space anyway. I'm out of sticks. Need more sticks. More sticks, more crops, more power. There. So now we can already begin our journey to make it from like 111 seeds to 10 times as powerful seeds, the maximum seeds. And the maximum seeds are great. Oh boy. I should, like, I have too much sugar cane, so I guess I'll just put the carrots in this plot instead. Like, yeah. Is it still flowing? Yeah, it's still flowing. Alright. My goodness, how far is my progress in here? Oh, right, the mushroom thing. Where's my mushroom thing? It's this thing over here. If I didn't have a mushroom, I could still use my, what's it called? I forgot. The gene, whatever the thingy. The thing that turns saplings into other saplings. Yeah, I have a bunch of saplings. I can turn those into other things. It includes mushrooms. That's how I got some of these weird mushrooms like this. I have to see if I can, like, turn it into the infection spore. Whatever it is. Can I turn it into a thing? Yes, I can. Punk. Infestation spores, okay. Now with this I can turn things into mycelium. It looks like a pasture seed, so I'll be careful with it for now. I'll just keep it in a chest. Like this chest for safekeeping. Here's some compost, here's some more compost. Right. Okay. I'll be chopping this tree down. These trees down now. So, that's the basic gist of it. Between episodes, I'll work on these crops. I'll gather more mana for that thing. Make compost, breed better plants, and Ah, right. I'll get some of these. Yeah. I'll claim that reward. Some mycelium, some whatever, yeah. It's great. So, the only thing left is some essence dust and some of these other quests. Which, like, yeah, I can't do these straight away, but I'll try to knock them off in the next episode or something, which can come anytime. I'm not gonna promise them coming out every week because I have like a life to do. But still, if I have the time, I'll try and post them the progress and stuff. Oh boy. Gotta climb up for this one. So, yeah. Next time, I'll knock off some more quests in the journal thing, in Bookface. And after I knock off those quests, then maybe I'll be able to move on. Like, where are the quests up here? Like, this one needs more essence stuff. This one needs that. This one here needs yeah, everything here needs stuff. I can make these, but like right now they are not essential to my progress. Like look at this one. It's like I don't know. There's stuff in there that's useful, I'm pretty sure, but like I can't cover it in one sitting. So, yeah. Yeah, I can't cover all that in one sitting. So, next, like if I progress on those side ones or something, I'll let you know. But like the main concern was this mana pool and these flowers. And honestly, that only takes like I guess time and replacing these day blooms if they wither out. So, yeah. Oh boy. I think that's about it. Like other than well, I am getting like saplings here that like yeah. I have enough saplings to replace this. Sure. Alright. So, next time, I will have more. I'll have more of these crops bred. I'll have this one ready. I'll have the essence stuff ready. I'll have the magical stuff ready that I can't do right now because I'm a horrible not wizard. But like yeah, eventually things will get going. But for now it's just a waiting game. So yeah. All right. Thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.